So basically, this is the world's first 360 drone that's under 250 grams.
Okay.
So actually extremely lightweight and small, and also can capture 8K full 360. So we have two fisheye lenses in the very up and very bottom of the drone, and captures that entire sphere, like everything around it. And then once you have that full 8K flying in the air, it transmits a live signal into this vision goggle. It essentially, it's like a VR headset. So okay. You can wear this headset, you can look to the left, you can look below you, you can look above, look around, even look back. It's amazing. So almost like you are flying.
Oh, this is brilliant. I think I saw the Hadvat. The Hadvat came out a couple of weeks ago.
Yeah.
Yes, and it's one of the drones that I'm so much interested in trying.
Thank you.
I have the DJI Mini 3.
Right.
And because of some downside on it, I decided, okay, let me get another one. It's a fantastic drone, don't get me wrong. Don't get me wrong, but this is one of the drones I would love to try out as well.
Thank you.
So aside from the 360 camera, what other features separate this from other drones like the DJI Mini?
I think one big difference is that when you are flying forward, you can still look in all the angles. So that was impossible with all the other drones. This is the only drone that's in the industry that can do this. So imagine you are flying in a straight line, and you can look below you, you can look over your shoulder, you can even look back. And it doesn't change the direction of the drone. So that's the fun part, because imagine when you are a Superman, you are flying in the air, you can look in all the angles. But with FPV drones, with all the other drones, if you want to look right, then you have to pivot the drone to the left. It changes the filming.
Oh, this is brilliant. And I think this is going to change the, it's going to change the dynamics about content creation in
exactly.
the future. Because most of the time when I'm flying my drone, I'm so worried about what's happening behind me.
Exactly.
Is my drone going to run into an obstacle?
Yes.
Because I've crashed my drone a couple of times.
Yes.
And that's an amazing innovation to know that even when you're flying your drone,
exactly.
you're still so much conscious about what is happening around you.
You can just look over your shoulder, almost like you are driving a car.
Oh, that's right. So what's the weight for this? Because I know the legal weight is 249.
Mm-hmm.
So is this also 249?
249. Yeah.
Oh, okay, this is brilliant. And what's the battery life? Like, when it's fully charged, how long can it fly for?
We have two types of batteries. So the standard battery can last more than 20 minutes, and the extended battery can last more than 30 minutes.
Brilliant.
Yeah.
Brilliant. That's a nice one. So when is this available for sale?
We expect it to be available around January next year.
January next year.
Yeah.
And do you have an idea how much this is going to cost?
We don't have the final pricing yet, but everything will come as a bundle, including the remote, the vision goggle, and also the drone.
So the vision goggle, is it a mandatory device to fly this drone?
It is. We think it's essential because only with this goggle you can have that immersive flying experience.
Okay, but that's going to require a different certification. Because, for instance, the DJI Mini that I own, I don't have a goggle for it. So the certification is a bit lesser than if I'm wearing an FPV drone. The only requirement is you must have a spotter, which is not really... So that means anytime I'm flying drones like this, I need to have someone next to me.
It's adjusted.
Gonna be, oh, okay.
Yes.
Wow, this is nice.
And also, it's very fun to fly with a spotter or your family or your friends. So normally with FPV drones, people, or even like normal drones, people never fly with their families because their families are so bored next to them. Like 30 minutes, they have nothing to do. But now we have actually a front screen in the goggle. So it shows exactly what the pilot is seeing. So the spotter or the families or the friends, they can see what the pilot is seeing from outside. So they can share the flight experience and talk to them.
That's nice, that's nice. And my last question is, does this have an obstacle avoidance sensor?
We do.
Okay, all 360.
So we have the front sensing sensors and we have bottom sensors. We don't have on the sides because essentially you don't need on the sides because you can just look around you.
Oh, okay. Yeah, that's a good one.
Yeah.
I'd love to try it out when it's out.
Thank you, thank you.
Yeah, thank you so much. Thank you.